Hi everyone, Magda from Coacharia here. I have with me today Tracy and Drayvon, who are both our lovely alumni and now associate trainers. They are starting a super interesting and very different program for aspiring coaches. And we thought it would be nice to introduce them and their program to our community. So here we are today with Tracy. Hello. And with Drayvon, who are joining us from Vancouver and from India, which is, and I'm in Chicago, so pretty cool and global as usual.
Yeah. Hi, Magda.
Let's start with introductions. What we're talking about today is your ontology-focused ACTP, which we will get to in a second, but let's first start with the two of you. Drayvon, do you want to kick us off? Who are you? Where are you? What makes you tick?
Yeah. So I'm based out of Bangalore, and I have had a 30-year-old career. The first 23 years being in the armed forces, I was a naval aviator. I left the Navy in 2014 and then started my journey in coaching organizations and doing systemic coaching. And subsequently, in that journey, I got myself credentialed through Coacharia, which I'm so proud of. And what I have really found most interesting in my journey, 30 years of studying different disciplines, including having a master's in psychology and Gestalt, NLP, you know, Theory U, courses from MIT, what I found extremely, extremely empowering was the subject ontology. So that's one of the reasons why this came up for me, that since ontology is such a powerful subject, why can't we marry this with coaching and explore what is possible? So that's essentially been my journey. And that is what I'm excited about delivering through the Coacharia platform.
Thank you. And Tracy, what's your story?
Hi, I'm Tracy. I'm currently based in Vancouver, Canada. And my journey has involved a lot of things. I was a single mother. I had several major career pivots, including going from accounting and finance to fashion to hospitality. And I had, I would say a few years back, just decided that I was going to get off that career track and really focus on myself. And that is where the journey began that has led me here. So it started off with me doing a lot of meditation, a lot of self-reflection, and then pursuing coach training, because coaching was something that I had done for years within one of my roles. And it provided me a lot of joy and a lot of purpose. And I thought, when I reconnected with myself, I thought, that's where I need to go. And so I joined Coacharia. And then through that, met Drayvon and learned about ontology and really started digging deeper into my being and absolutely am fascinated not just with my being, but the study of being in general. And that has led me here. So really excited to share this with you and really work through weaving it with the coaching process and explore.
You know, it just occurred to me, not only have the three of us never met in person, but the two of you went through an entire coach training program together, and now you'll be working together and teaching others, and you have never met in person.
We haven't.
Wow.
We haven't.
Yeah.
This is kind of crazy.
I think we connect more than what we do with most people we've met in person. So.
Yeah.
I was
Which
thinking
is the beauty
about
of virtual training, right?
I was thinking about that yesterday, and I was thinking, I had this scene in my mind of like finally going to India, because you know that's been on my bucket list. I've talked to you about that, and visions of being met at the airport by Drayvon and his wife, and just, yeah.
Yes,
it's going to happen. Yes, and Chicago is also on my bucket list, so.
Okay, in Chicago, it'll be very much easier for me to meet you at the airport. When I went to India for the first and only time, my plane landed at 1 a.m. So Ram did not meet me, and I had my first experience of being driven by a stranger in Indian driving style, which, oh my God, I mean, I survived.
Next time you come, let us know. I will be there to pick you up, Magda.
Okay, cool. And I know how to go through the visa controls now too, because that was a doozy. Anyway, back to the topic. So we are gathered here today to talk about ontology. So first and foremost, let's start with the basics. What is ontology?
I'm going to allow Drayvon to jump in and talk about
Yeah, Magda, in one simple line, ontology is essentially the study of the nature of being. And it's a subject which is dedicated to studying being. And since coaching is a wonderful space where a coach shows up essentially from the being that he is or she is, it becomes a very important aspect of coaching. It becomes a central theme of what a coaching process is, because the being is what really holds space for a person's presence, a person's mindset, a coach's mindset, etc. So exploring being deeply becomes an automatic question, which it came up for me that why not integrate these two subjects, which is focused essentially on being, and the central theme of coaching is coming from holding your being in the highest possible version, the expression of yourself. So that's essentially what ontology is and why it is can be brought into coaching in a big way.
So coach training programs in general, there are specific things that we cover, both in terms of what we as an organization think that coaches should know, as well as the requirements that we need to fulfill in order for the coaches to qualify for coaching credentials. So the biggest part of that, of course, is coaching competencies. In this particular course that you are doing, which will be broken up like regular coach training into kind of the foundational stuff and then a little bit more than that, depending on the hours that somebody wants to complete, how are you bringing ontology in? What can people expect in terms of what will be covered and how it will be covered?
We'll be, of course, covering everything within the coaching foundation, and then we basically designed a program that's going to be weaving ontology all throughout that. So as we're covering each of the competencies, we'll be looking at those from, of course, the aspect of what the expectations are within the certain credentialing bodies, as well as coach training perspectives. And then we'll sort of be shining light on those from an ontology perspective as well, and kind of digging a little bit deeper. And one of the things that's a little bit different about this is that although, of course, there is going to be lots of information, the ontology approach is very transformational. So it is going to be a little bit more of an exploration and a little more of a transformational approach to complement the coaching foundation.
So in practice, that I'm guessing means a little bit more coaching.
Exactly. Lots of coaching, lots of reflection. And because we are aware that this is also a little bit of a different process for many people, we'll also be offering one-on-one coaching as well to the participants to help them with their reflections and their digestion of everything. Mm.
Drayvon, anything else you want to add?
Yes, this is essentially a process which is very different from acquiring a lot of information about subjects. We start with a base of no definitions, no descriptions. It's more about a deep dive into an exploration about what kind of a presence do we feel and how do we connect with these spaces? How do we connect with these competencies? And it's trying to establish a very deep connection such that the competencies show up on their own during the coaching process. That is the whole essence of what an ontological deep dive is all about. The process is hugely based on self-reflections and introspections. So it's like peeling off layers, like peeling off an onion. It's going to be a process of peeling off those layers and going deeper and deeper into each of these competencies and connecting with them at the core of yourself, connecting up at that level. That is what an ontological process is. It's different than acquiring a whole lot of information about lots and lots of theories. So it's we will be touching upon all those theories, which are extremely essential. It's an essential part of the process. But the focus would be to help the participants connect deeply with the competencies at a level which is beyond their awareness. You know, it's just going more deeper.
That is so basically, if you're someone who wants to see a bunch of slides, don't come to this class.
Yes, true.
Exactly. Absolutely. We're not trying we're not looking to cram a lot of information in. We're really looking for understanding.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So and yeah, just for anyone who's watching, I just want to mention that, of course, everyone who participates in this program will still get access to all the content, all the support, et cetera, that Coacharya offers to anyone who's doing coach training. This just will be a little different. And I'm thinking of it more personally challenging. I mean, not everybody wants to look within themselves. So I think this is going to be a pretty cool journey for the coach, not just for the coaching that they will do eventually.
Absolutely. You got that right, Magda, because by the end of all the sessions that we have done, by the end of all the courses that we've done, the coach per se is left in a very empowered state. The kind of expression, the power the coach feels because of the deep connection first established within themselves, and that helps them in the coaching process during their sessions which they take on, because it starts kind of pouring out. They become the source of being able to hold that kind of space during a coaching session. And what you said is correct, because we have experimented with this without sharing the video recordings, without sharing the slide decks. And initially they feel a bit of that something is missing here. But very soon they realize that the reflections which keep coming through the week, week after week after week, it starts deepening so beautifully that they start realizing that the recordings and the presentations are not the place where all that transformation is happening. The transformation is happening within, and because of the deep reflection and introspection, which is part and parcel of an ontological process. That is where the course is going to be different.
So I have a question about kind of the day-to-day. So all of our courses for coach training at Coacharya are virtual, and they take place once a week for 3 hours. And we use Zoom just like we are for this particular recording. So I know how to explain what should happen in a regular class. What can learners expect at a typical class with you, with this ontological approach?
In a typical class with us, there will be, of course, some topics that we are going to be covering specifically within that class, but it really is a class discussion. So sometimes it'll be a discussion with the entire group. At times we'll be facilitating breakout rooms so people get a chance to discuss in threes or fours, depending on the class size, and we come back and share. And that's generally the format of the class. And of course, once we get into coaching, there'll be breakout rooms as well with coaching conversations. And we would possibly be doing some coaching demonstrations in class also.
So this brings me to my next question. What kind of person should join this program? A few things I've already picked up. You have to have an open mind and be ready to both listen and to talk. So I know that some coach training institutes just let you kind of dial in. This is not that kind of course. You have to be on video, you have to be on audio, and you have to have your mind open and focused on the group and the topic. Other than that, is there a particular kind of person, do you think, that will benefit more than others from this kind of training?
Well, my thoughts are that most people that are going into coaching are already ready to sort of do a lot of reflection. They're open to doing some inner work. And mm-hmm. So really that would be the type of person that we're looking for, is someone that's really interested in exploring this and thinking about it a little bit differently and digging a little bit deeply. And one of the things I also wanted to mention is that even though this is a very reflective course, the reflections are really meant for people to learn about themselves and their own beings. So we also give them the option as to what they want to share and what they don't want to share. And so they're not expected to come into class and sort of unpack themselves if they're not ready to do that. It's really just about being willing to commit to going there, but you don't have to share where you've gone.
Mm-hmm. Drayvon, anything to add?
No, I think she's right. It's more about a person who would really want to know themselves deeply and prioritize that, and realize that that is where the power would come from in their coaching session subsequently once they get credentialed. It's a very deep understanding of yourself, which is what becomes possible in this journey. That becomes the source of everything. Really connecting deeply with yourself, with your own power, with your own competencies, which are innately existing in each one of us. It's just about discovering it, and we help create a structure which they use, the support of that structure in kind of peeling off the layers and really getting connected to those competencies which do exist inside all of us. So that is what we enable through this process. So anybody who's interested in getting it in that fashion, I think would be interested in this kind of a course.
It's like the ultimate unconditional positive regard.
For themselves to start with.
And exactly what you said, it's for ourselves to start with. And then of course, from there, we can shift to looking at it from the client's context and how to be with a client and how that weaves into coaching presence and coaching skills. So it's definitely starting with oneself, but then it's expanding into how we show up as coaches and how we show up in the world.
So it strikes me as this course and this approach would be just as useful to someone who wants to get their coaching credentials and wants to become a really good coach, but also for people who maybe have had some coach training, but they want to grow as coaches, as people get that self-reflection to a deeper level than they may have had elsewhere. So it's not necessarily a one size fits all, but basically if you have an open mind and you want to learn about coaching, come on over.
Absolutely. The program that we're running now, we have coaches attending. So they're there because they're interested in deepening their beings as coaches.
Yeah. So I should add that what we are talking about today is an ACTP, so an accredited coach training program, which once you completed, you will fulfill your training requirement for credentials with ICF, EMCC, or CCE. But for those of you watching who are already accredited and or practicing coaches, but you want to learn more about ontology and get the same kind of experience, we will be offering standalone ontology for credentialed coaches a little bit later in the year. So with the same lovely people who you see today, with a lot of the same kind of reflections that are happening. So if you already have a credential, don't click stop. Look at the notes, look for our contact information, which is also contact@coachearea.com, and please reach out to us, and we will be happy to put you in touch with Tracy and Drayvon for either this upcoming course, which at the time of this recording, we are recording this in July, I think is the 16th, I don't actually know, 17th. The course starts in August, but I think this is going to be pretty amazing. So even if you're watching this, you know, a year from now, information still applies. Please find Coach Arya, and I'm sure this ontology thing will be an ongoing initiative because it's pretty different and pretty cool, I think. Any closing words, Drayvon and Tracy?
Yeah, Tracy.
Thank you very much, and really excited about this program, really excited about exploring it and inviting anyone that's watching this to check it out.
Yeah. Thanks for this, for giving us this platform to be able to reach out to all the people who are interested in really, you know, discovering themselves very powerfully. And that is what we want to do. Not only coach, but discover yourself powerfully and be deeply rooted and connected with who you are and finding that source of power from within. And that's why it became interesting for us to marry these two disciplines of ontology and coaching, and it seemed like a natural kind of a marriage of two disciplines. It just seemed too natural for us. That's why we're exploring this, and we know for sure that it turns out to be pretty powerful in the end.
Look, it makes sense to me. You can only know others only when you know yourself, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah. Great. Thank you so much for your time today. Anyone who has questions, like I said, you know how to reach us wherever you are watching or listening to this, because this will be on a podcast as well. Please take a look at the episode and or video notes, where you will find a link to our website, information on how to contact us and to register to work with Tracy and Drayvon. And you'll also find links to profiles of these two amazing people who I'm very, very proud are Coacharya alumni. And for me personally, it's pretty cool when alumni take our programs, which we already thought were great, and then make them even better. It's pretty awesome. So thank you guys for your support. Thank you to everyone who's watching and listening. And I will see you next time with something else that's pretty cool and amazing about Coacharya. Bye.